schedule here. So the first speaker wins the creative award for best title for the session, Sherlock Holmes and the Cryptic Case of API Security. What's going on here?
We are home with breaking news. There has been a data security breach at the popular investing site Robinhood. More than 7 million customers
discovered an Experian application programming interface on a student loan vendor's website, allowing any user to look up the credit score of hundreds of millions of Americans by supplying simple information. And this API required no authentication whatsoever.
While Experian a breach involving the networking site LinkedIn, and this
was reportedly investigating a data breach involving up to 100 million customers.
30 million people who applied for T-Mobile credit was stolen.
Streaming platform Twitch says a malicious third party is behind a massive data breach of the website.
Revealing private information, including names, addresses, and driver's license numbers of Californians who were granted or denied a concealed weapons permit between 2011 and 2021.
Microsoft is announcing that it's found another wave of attacks by the Russian intelligence service that is active.
An annual report says 2021 saw a record number of cyber attacks of 68%.
Over 140 million consumers were compromised by hackers that are still unidentified.
The data also contains addresses of hundreds of defense sites, a Navy missile maintenance unit, bombing ranges. There were also weapons storage facilities.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, I ask that you please remain in your seats as this has now been designated an API crime scene. Please try not to touch or contaminate any of the evidence you might come across, as we're going to be moving very quickly to solve this case. My name is Brenton House. I'm the lead detective on this case. I am also an ex-hacker, developer, architect, filmmaker, and digital evangelist at Software AG. Now, if I look at my notes, this is a group that has volunteered to help me on this case. So let's get started. All right. In the next 15 minutes, we're going to solve a real-world case. We're going to do that by applying three principles from Sherlock Holmes. So we're going to determine what happened and what could have been done to prevent this. Now, it's very important that you remember these three principles because there will be an exam later. So, the first principle is know your resources. So, Sherlock Holmes always knew who and what was available to him as a resource. He had contacts in the police department and pretty much every other community. So, he took advantage of these resources and he then leveraged them. He could then leverage the resources to be able to find who and what could help him solve a crime. Each resource might be different for each situation, but he had to use that judgment. First, we had know your resources. Second, we have know your situation. So Sherlock Holmes once said, "I've trained myself to see things that others overlook." Sherlock Holmes is known for his keen sense of observation and deduction. But in order to see all the clues that were available to him, he had to hone those skills. So he observed everything that was in his world around him. He would then use this information to make educated deductions based on facts, data, and on patterns. Okay, so number one, we had know your resources. Two, we had know your situation. And three, we have know your adversary. Sherlock Holmes was always quick to learn as much as possible about who he was up against, whether that was his arch nemesis, Professor Moriarty, or a common criminal. He would study their methods, their tools, their weapons, and their thought processes. So we have resources, situation, and adversary. If it helps you remember acronym RSA, then go ahead and use that. All right, before we can take a look at this case together, I need everyone to take the Sherlock Holmes API detective examination. Now, I've been told that you are the best and the brightest here in Hub 2. So I'm gonna need you to speak your answers clearly and loudly, so that everyone in Hub 1 and 3 knows that hub to rocks. All right. So we have know your. Okay. I'm not sure the guy in the back of the room could hear you guys. Let's try that again. Know your. All right. Excellent. Next, know your. Great. And know your. Okay. Great job. You guys definitely live up to your reputation. So let's take a look at this case. So the case that we're going to look at today is a Peloton API breach. So in January of 2021, a security researcher discovered that an unauthenticated user could access the Peloton API and gain access to user data for any user, including those that had their profile marked as private. So the data that was exposed include user IDs, instructor IDs, workout information, geolocation, age, gender, and more. So let's take a quick look at the timeline. So first, the vulnerability was discovered, and it was reported to Peloton using the official Peloton reporting tool. It was also, they were given a standard 90-day window to address the issue before it would go public. Next thing that happened was, well, nothing. Peloton didn't respond publicly or privately to the researcher. Next, after a couple weeks, the API was quietly, quote unquote, fixed. And what I mean by that was now the API was only accessible by those that were authenticated. Now, can anyone tell me really quickly why that's not a fix? Well, if the API was required authentication, but not authorization policy. So any authenticated user could get into the API, but then still access data for any other user. So again, Peloton was notified that their fix didn't work. And the next was after the 90-day window, Peloton, the press was notified. Press went to Peloton, then Peloton started responding. After a couple weeks, the API was then secured and Peloton performed a public disclosure. But by that time, so much damage had been done. All right, let's apply the three principles that we just learned to this case. First is know your resources. Now, there are a lot of API security resources out there. There are great websites, there are great videos and YouTube channels, but most importantly, there is the OWASP top 10 list for API security. Now, the OWASP top 10 list for API security includes the top security vulnerabilities for APIs. This is going to be an essential toolkit for your API security strategy. Okay, so let's take a look at the Peloton API case using this list. We can see that they had broken object level authorization, broken user authentication, and excessive data exposure. At the very least, there may have been more. What that means simply is that they didn't check who you were, they didn't check that you had permissions to do what you wanted to do, and three, they were sending way too much information. In Peloton's case, they were sending personal information about private users. Next is know your situation. Situational awareness with API security is so important. You have to know what different types of APIs are out there, but you also have to know what APIs you have, what you're consuming, and what you're producing. You also need to know what your API cybersecurity strategy is. Now, for most organizations, cybersecurity is a priority. However, for a lot of CISOs and cybersecurity experts, API security is a gap for them. Case in point, the Peloton API. So when President Biden decided that he was going to bring a Peloton bike into the White House, a group of cybersecurity experts came together to look at the situation. They analyzed the situation, they looked at the bike, locked it down, and assured everyone that it was completely safe because this could not be hacked into. Obviously, their API security was a gap because an unauthenticated user could go in and see the data for any user, including the President of the United States. All right, I already said that there's a lot of different types of APIs. We have public, external, open, internal, partner, machine-to-machine, third-party APIs, composite, and then your beta and testing. Now, if we look at the Peloton case, you can see that they were using a machine-to-machine API, which is common with IoT devices and servers. But this type of API is often neglected with API security when compared to the other types of APIs. But these are not the only types of APIs that exist out there. There are also unknown APIs, such as shadow APIs, and those are APIs you try and keep off the radar. Zombie APIs, and those APIs work great, but they haven't been updated in forever and are missing critical security patches. And Frankenstein APIs, and those are APIs are hacked together. They can be public or internal, but it's because they want to access data from a system whose API is either incomplete or non-existent. So again, if we look at the Peloton case, we can see that it's kind of a form of shadow API because they tried to keep this API off the radar and undocumented. They also tried to use something which is often called security by obscurity, which we know doesn't work. All right, now this is where the rubber meets the road. Know your adversary. With API security, it is important that you are able to get into the mind of your adversary if you are going to properly manage and secure your APIs. I'm going to start with some blue team defensive tools here. You have your API gateway. Now, this is so important. This is going to be the core and foundation for your API security. Everything is going to be based on this. You also have web application firewalls, or WAFs. These provide an additional layer of protection using artificial intelligence and machine learning. And you also have other API security tools. And these are typically dedicated API security tools that can be used to provide your shift left features, which help you at design time and development, and your shield right features, which protect your API at runtime. Now, there are also red team offensive tools. Now, I'm not going to go into details on a lot of these tools, but I will tell you this. You need to have an understanding of what tools could be used by someone to gain access to your APIs or just to discover vulnerabilities in your APIs. It's worth your time to at least know what these tools are and how they work. So we looked at knowing your resources, knowing your situation, and knowing your adversary. But there's also a bonus, and that is knowing where you're going. Your API strategy, your API security strategy that you have is very important. You also need to know where your gaps are, not just in your security, but in your knowledge of API security. Keep learning. So continue your API cybersecurity learning journey by learning whatever you can, but it's important to know what you don't know. Now, I have API Cybersecurity 101 series out on YouTube. You can find that at youtube.com/Brenton House, but also check out, there's an API Shorts YouTube channel and the Software AG YouTube channel. There are also some great web resources out there, and I highly suggest you take a look at apisecurity.io. So Colin has a fantastic newsletter and website that really helps people stay up to date on the changing world of API security. You can also check out my website at brenton.house, and also check out softwareag.com to learn about the products and the tools that can help you securely manage your APIs.
All right. We learned a lot by looking at the Peloton case through the eyes of Sherlock Holmes. We learned about knowing your resources, knowing your situation, knowing your adversary, but also about knowing what you know. Now, I appreciate everyone's help in solving this case, and I look forward to solving our next case together. If you want to get in touch with me at all, you can feel free to connect with me on LinkedIn and send me a message there as well. And I believe we might have time for any questions, or we also have a giveaway here.